now. Karen, they be sharing all their money, got me wearing fly. Girl, but I ain't asking. They say they love my ass in 7G.
Hey guys, welcome to Artistry and Friends Quarantine Lockdown Beats with me.
To introduce myself, my name is Kathleen, but I am known as Glam by Kat on Instagram. If you guys are new here, then please subscribe to my channel. It means a lot and it helps me out so much. Today we are doing this fabulous look. If you guys want to know how to achieve this look, then please keep on watching. Alright guys, so we are going to begin this eye look that I did. Please ignore that my eye is red. It has been irritated for a while, but that doesn't stop me from doing a makeup look. Alright guys, so we're going to begin and beat our face to the gods. We're going to begin into this eye, and I think I'm going to zoom you guys in just so you guys can get a better view of the look. All right guys, so you are up close and personal. Let's get into this look. Prime my eyes. I am using the ABH eye primer. I literally live for this stuff. I like to use a little bit because a little does go a long way. So now that we are primed and ready, we are going to begin on the look. Right, so in the Norvina palette, we are going with the shade A5, and we're going to pick up this shade on a Morphe M441 brush. And notice in the crease, I am going to bring the shadow up a little bit to my eyebrow. We are still focusing the shadow in the crease. So now I'm going to drag this pink shadow, and I'm just going to drag it down a bit. Like right there, and then I'm gonna spur it really like an airbrush effect. So we are gonna go for that airbrush look, and this is gonna be our main base color. But once that shade is blended out, we are going to dive in with the Amrazy palette, and we're gonna dive with that color Sesma. This brush works really well, and I'm just going to work this shade in our crease. So I'm just using the shade, and it's just going to give us a more smoky effect on the lid. And I really like the way that this color plays out. As you can see, it just gave us a purple layering with our pink shade. So once we have that shade packed on, I am going to use a blending brush, and I'm just going to blend those two shades together for a more seamless look. So I really wanted to create a look that was very easy for you guys. My regular subbies know that I love to create easy looks. Sometimes I can do a little bit of complex looks, but I really like to work with cut creases and, you know, like graphics on my eye. I've never really worked with black shades, but I was like, you know what? I need to spice it up a little. And it came out really, really nice. I think this look will be cute, you know, when you're with your boo or when you're by yourself in your room and you could just like take pictures, or you could tell your boyfriend to take pictures. That's what I do. What really brings this look to life is that black shade, and it is in our outer corner. The palette that I'm using is the Daisy Marquez palette. We're gonna dive in with that shade Matter, and of course we have to remember to always tap our brushes, give it a little tap, you know. So with the black, I am really just going to tap and stamp on where I want the black. I have been very like off, you know. I've been really trying to get back into doing YouTube because it is really like what I really love to do, and it just gets me out of my funks that I'm usually in. So I am gonna blend this black shade in, and it is gonna look a little bit crazy, but once we cut the crease, it's gonna look flawless. So how has everyone's quarantine been? Mine, I have just been keeping busy. I have been doing TikToks, and I've been researching a lot about an upcoming project that I am in the works for, and I have been spending time with my family more, which is just so grateful because I'm going back to college here. I'm going back. I don't want to go back because I'm so scared like what's gonna happen. But if you guys don't know, I am a college student, and I'm having my first apartment, so please stay in tune with that. Sorry I got a little distracted. I just love speaking to you guys. To cut my crease, I am using the e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealer, and this is in the shade Medium Sand. And I am using a JH42 brush. I like to just put a little bit of concealer on my lid and then I look up. So with the concealer, I am just going to pat this through. And I'm not going to let the cut crease be as structured. I'm going to dive in with the shade Wasted in the same Amreezy palette. And we are just going to coat this in our shadow. It has a little bit of shimmer in it, which I like. So I do want to talk about TikTok just because like I have been using it so much. I feel like I have been vibing on that app. So if you guys have TikTok, please follow me. I'm gonna just blend out that black shade a little with Wasted. I'm gonna go back in with the A5 shadow and I'm just gonna blend the pink in with the black. And I'm just diving in with Wasted one more time just to give us a more faded out effect. So I want you guys to let me know, what do you think about the Jeffree Star Cremated palette? I was a little iffy about it, but I'm really liking the colors. It's just the color name was just like not for me. I know people are really against it. Just due to someone that's really been affected through the pandemic gets on my nerves with the name, but I do understand that it takes a long time for someone to create a palette. And I know he wasn't gonna stop all productions with it. So I'm not throwing shade, but that's my tea on the palette. Now this is up to my favorite part. So we are using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Liquid Eyeliner. And this liner is so black. I love it. So as you guys can see right now, I just extended the line a little bit higher with the M46 brush, and I'm gonna go in with that black shade that we used in the Daisy Marquez palette, and I am just gonna blend this black shadow in with the eyeliner. So now that the eyes are done, I am just going to put on my favorite lashes and we will be right back. All right guys, so I popped on my Batty Bee lashes in plastic. They're like $14. You cannot go wrong. All right guys, so I am using the Milk Hydro Grip primer, and this primer works wonders. I'm gonna warm it up first and I'm gonna move it around my face. The next primer I like to use is the Fenty primer, and I like to just use this on my T-zone. Once we are primed, my foundation that I'm using today is the Wet n Wild Total Focus Dewy Luxe Foundation, and this is in the shade Golden Beige. So I still want to talk about the concept of like quarantine, and I think like starting up YouTube channels really do bring out creativity. It really does bring out opportunities too for people. Hence why I am here. I haven't told you guys like what I have grown from, you know, actually doing YouTube and like putting myself out there. I have gained multiple opportunities to work with brands. I also created a dream board. I really manifest in those dream boards and they actually come to life. And I'm so thankful and grateful that all those dreams have actually came true. So I found this trick on TikTok. Obviously, I found most of my tricks on TikTok. And you're only highlighting like your highest point, so obviously you have to be very careful here. So I'm gonna highlight this part, and I'm gonna highlight under my eyes. And this is gonna give us a more awake look. Once our face is all blended in, I'm going to bake with my Fenty Beauty powder. And I'm gonna pat this powder under my eye. I have been doing this recently on my routine, so I'm just going to buff in that powder into my face, and the buffing effect is going to give us a more airbrush look. I'm going to begin contour. Contour has been my favorite thing to do for the past weeks during quarantine. I'm going to speed up this process because I know this video has been super duper long. And for bronzer, I am diving in with the Dragon Beauty face palette, and I'm gonna use the shade Femme. I'm just gonna contour my highest points. I'm gonna do circular motions. I feel like that works out for me. And for my nose, I'm just going to make a little bit of a swivel. I like to do this technique just to make sure that all the powder is there. And for blush, I love a very soft pinky blush, and I am using the Kylie Pressed Blush Powder in Pink Power. And for highlight, I love a blinding highlight, and I'm using the Iconic Drops. Now, I got this on my BoxyCharm. Don't think I'm bougie like that, because I'm not. So I like to just put it on my highest temples with my fingers. Blend it out, put it a little on my nose. I like to put a little bit right here. And for highlight, I like to use the Anastasia Ambrezy highlight. And when I smile, it's my favorite to do right on my apples of my cheeks. So cute. And for lips, I like to use my Carly Bible Il Maquillage lip liner in the shade Luna. Now I am going to use the lipstick that comes with the collection, and this is in the shade Libra. And of course, it will not be my type of look if I did not use a lip gloss. So I'm using the Artist Couture lip gloss in the shade Uncensored. So this lip gloss literally brings your lips to dull lips, you know, to pop and juicy lips. I love how it's just like a nude lip and it's true to the color. Okay, so I do want to spice up this look just a little bit, and I'm going to apply some rhinestones. So guys, this is the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like, comment, and subscribe as usual. And please let me know if you guys like this look. I feel like it was bomb for a nice comeback. And I apologize so much. I am going to be on my grind. I have a couple of videos that I can upload. Stay tuned to that, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.